Repairing a south of 12-inch steam pump, this one is part 10. Partially dismantling the pump to repair the shuttle piston, plus fitting a shim to one of the slide valves and adjusting the slide valve operating mechanism. Testing the mechanical lubricator, followed by full reassembly. And then a compressed air test to see if it works. In this clip, I've been removing all the bolts that hold the top cover in place on the steam chest. I'm fairly sure that all these problems are due to the shuttle valve. Unfortunately, to remove the shuttle valve to look at it, I need to take off the steam chest cover and the steam chest and remove the valves. I removed all these parts very carefully because I want to preserve the state of the positions of the valves in the steam chest. And I can immediately see that the main shuttle piston valve is not in a very good position. I machined it as per the drawing, but I don't think the shuttle valve is 100% as per the drawing. The problem is, as far as I can see it, there is too much play between the quarter of an inch diameter centre part of the shuttle piston and the slide valve. But worse than that, here is a shuttle piston, and this is not good at all. Initially, I was going to make another shuttle piston, but I think the only thing wrong with this is someone's fitted a second O-ring. What I am going to do is poke my scriber down inside the shuttle piston cylinder and just scrape the end to make sure there isn't any silicone rubber down there. It's quicker than removing the bottom plate. This seems fine and nothing seemed to come out of the hole after a blast with compressed air. When you use silicone O-rings on pistons or shuttle valves like this one, the silicone O-ring needs to be exactly the same external diameter as the cylinder is internally. And the metal part of the cylinder, or the shuttle piston like this one I'm cleaning up, does not need to be a tight fit. It's the O-ring that does the sealing, not the piston. In the Myford lathe, I'm cleaning the shuttle piston with some 400 grit wet-to-dry sandpaper. I've done this before on many steam pumps, and it seems to work fine. After 3 or 4 minutes with the wet-to-dry sandpaper, the piston is now a slightly smaller diameter, a very slightly smaller diameter. If this doesn't work, I will make a new shuttle piston. I've turned it round in the chuck to do the other end, and you will notice that there is only one groove for an O-ring at this end, not two like on the other end. Previously, even without the O-rings, this shuttle piston was quite a tight fit in the shuttle piston cylinder. Now it feels a lot smoother. In this clip, I've fitted a silicone O-ring into each of the grooves at one end of the shuttle piston. The groove isn't wide enough or deep enough, and the silicone O-ring is far too tight. I removed it, and I'm just going to use one silicone O-ring at each end. When I refitted the shuttle piston into the shuttle piston cylinder and tried some compressed air, it was in a different class, with a lot more power and no sticking. Before reassembly, I fitted another brass shim in the slot of the shuttle piston's valve. This moved it quite a lot closer to the actual port face, which should be a good thing. I'm going to refit the top cover just using 4 bolts to see what happens. I haven't made a gasket for this part yet, because it doesn't seem to leak, but I won't really know about this until I do the steam test. Now comes the fun part. I need to adjust these pairs of lock nuts so that the valve spindle is in the right position relative to the actuating arm. And once again, this assembly is not made to the drawing. Please be aware that this is a repair, not a rebuild. A lot of me is wanting to sort of tear it down and remake all the parts, but the budget just isn't there. It wouldn't be worth it. This brass block is not right at all. It's not meant to have a piece of tube through the middle. It's meant to be quite a slack fit. I've placed a couple of O-rings on the end of the shafts to stop it sliding off. To get the pump just right, this takes a long time. And then you run it on compressed air and it's fine. Then you run it on steam and you may need to readjust these 2 lock nuts at each end of the valve spindle. Health and safety, do not do it like this. I'm doing it while the engine is running, which is not recommended, but it's the only excitement I get in my life these days. Please be aware that a pump of this size could cause serious injury. As this is a water pump, I think it's a good idea to test whether it pumps water. And indeed it does, and very well. Unlike the test in an earlier episode, the pump is now self-priming, and in no time at all, it's pumping water to and from the water container. And unlike the initial test when I first started to dismantle the pump, this is now double acting. The question is though, will it pump against boiler pressure? Let me think. The piston in the steam cylinder is fitted with a cast iron piston ring. The valves are all new. The port face has been skimmed. So yes, it should do. If I squeeze the return pipe to the water bottle, This will simulate pumping against pressure. I just hope that the water pipes don't blow out of the water chest. The pump's starting to bed in now, it's making a much better noise. And I think it's time to squeeze the pipe as tight as I can. When I turn the pressure up, the pump really is working well now. Time to stop the pump and finish the reassembly. This valve on the exhaust may be a bit of a puzzle, and it is a bit of a puzzle to me really. By closing the valve slightly and putting some exhaust back pressure into the system, the pump runs a lot more smoothly. This is pumping water quite well now. You can see it by the way the silicone rubber tubing is dancing about. You can hear how the sound of the pump changes as I close the valve slightly. That's enough water pumping. I disconnected the water and now the pump sounds like this. At this stage I removed both of the O-rings that I put on the shafts, and thankfully the valve block is now staying inboard of the shafts, it's not trying to fall off them. Before I refit the pump to its mounting, I need to make sure that the lubricator works, so here I'm putting some steam oil in the lubricator. In this clip I'm moving the arm back and forth quite a lot. I need to make sure that the steam oil is going down the pipe. Once it comes out of the other end, I'll be happy. This took quite a while. I had to keep stopping because my hand was aching. And there's still nothing much coming out of the end of the pipe. In case you're wondering what this is, it's a non-return valve in line with the pipe. There is a small non-return valve fitted at the bottom of the pump, but these are never enough on their own. You generally need a second one. If there's any blowback of steam, indicated by the steam oil being a very bright khaki colour, then the oil pump is not working. I was very pleased to finally see some oil coming out of the end of the pipe, so everything is okay there. On the steam inlet to the steam chest is a really big handle, and this operates a steam inlet valve. In my opinion, this tap is in a very bad position, so when I send it back to the owner, I'm going to remove it and put it in the box, so it doesn't get broken. And now it's time to put it all together. I'm bolting the pump to the base, and I've connected it to the oil pump, but when I connect the reciprocating arm to the oil pump, it needs to be in another hole, so that the arm moves more. When I do that, everything's fine, and the mechanism of the oil pump is working perfectly. Apart from making a brass lid for the mechanical lubricator, that's about it. Here's a quick deja vu sequence from when I first got the pump, to show you what state it was in. It was pretty grim really. When I first looked at it, I think I shuddered, and it's taken quite a bit longer than I thought it would do to make it run properly. Removing silicone rubber took long enough, then I had to deal with this mess by remachining the port face. But in the end, the repair is successful and the pump runs quite well. I replaced the O-rings on the end of the shaft just to persuade the valve block to stay where it is. The problem now is the pump is designed to be fitted to a vertical flat surface, and I soon got fed up of having to hold it in an upright position, so I thought, well, I'll lay it on its side. But before that, I felt the need to have a quick fiddle with the valve on the exhaust. My compressor is only very small, and soon the air went a bit below what is required to make it work. But when I opened the valve, it burst back into life, so I think it's okay. With the pump sat on its side on the bench, I'm going to leave it like this to the end of the video. I'd just like to say stay healthy, thanks for watching, and I hope you found it useful. please take the time to visit my main Steam Models website and click on the section of the website that says Video Playlists. And by doing that, you can find other videos that you may like to watch. And by using the playlists, you can actually watch the videos back to back.